Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Aloha mai kakou. Thank you for being here. We appreciate the discussions that your visit has started. I just, a little background about myself. I have a PhD in organic chemistry from the University of Florida. I moved to Minnesota. I worked at 3M for 8 years, and I felt the calling to come to Hawaii, and I came here in 1995. I've lived in Manoa Valley. I lived in Nanakuli for 3 years, and that's where my Hawaiian education really began. And I felt the sadness, I felt the sorrow, and I felt this is not a part of the United States of America. I always felt that. That was me. And I speak especially to people who have moved here, maybe not from the island, not born on the island. Quickly, the short history is two things really helped me out. The Pinky Show video and Hawaiian Sovereignty and International Law by David Kanusai, PhD at the University of Hawaii. Thank you. This, the kingdom was already recognized. Many people have said this. 46 different treaties were in place. There were constitutions, 1840, 1852, 1864. Then King David Kalakaua was bayoneted into signing the bayonet constitution, which allowed aliens to vote. So the overthrow, which happened in 1993, was just by a group of individuals. From what I've seen, this is my research that I've just done in the last week or so. The second thing is, a treaty of annexation was proposed. Grover Cleveland said no. The takeover was illegal. So all these things keep lining up and lining up. Then there's the apology resolution. And then there's statehood, which really was not a correct statehood-type vote. And all this and all that. So my final thing is, these events and documents display a pattern of deception and attempts to undermine and delegitimize the Kingdom of Hawaii by the U.S. government. The kingdom never ended. We are living not in the United States of America, not in the state of Hawaii. We are living in the Kingdom of Hawaii. Thank you.